And what we're learning lately about Omicron is that it is replicating much faster than Delta does. Obviously, people at the CDC are watching it very carefully. But what we know is that the best thing to do is to be prepared by vaccinating yourself. I think that, yes, it's a virus, and therefore there will be more mutations. But the answer is always the same, that regardless of how many mutations happen, we just need to protect ourselves by doing the right things, you know, vaccine and masking and all that.
You make up for it in volume, and that's why Omicron is so scary. It appears to be significantly more transmissible, and that means even if it's 30% or 50% less severe on an individual basis, we'll produce so many cases that need to be hospitalized that will overrun our healthcare system. And our healthcare system, as we've discussed, is already stretched to the max right now. We're at significant risk because we have a relatively low percentage of our population that is fully vaccinated and boosted, which is necessary to prevent transmission. And so I think we're at risk for a very large outbreak of Omicron here in the coming weeks. Everybody who has not been vaccinated yet, please, please go out and get vaccinated. We know that vaccination reduces severity of illness, and it appears that that's the case with Omicron as well. It's also true that vaccination that's recent and boosting for people who've been fully vaccinated previously probably reduces transmission of Omicron from person to person. It's possible that only one of the currently available monoclonal antibody treatments in the U.S. will have retained effectiveness against Omicron. It does appear that remdesivir, the antiviral drug that we've used, is probably still effective against Omicron, and some of the newer antiviral drugs that we don't yet have on the market and in our healthcare settings may still be effective, but we don't have data yet.